Okay, we'll get as far as we can in the next, like, 20 minutes. Let's see how far we go. Oh, we're in Utsunomiya. Yeah. Harada and I traveled in great haste to Utsunomiya, reuniting safely with Nagakura upon her arrival.
Oh, Sono! Chizuru-chan! You're both safe, right? Look
at the same way. この俺がそう簡単に死ぬはずがねえだろうが。
まあそりゃそうか。なんせ腹を切っても死ななかったぐらいだもんな。新政府軍の奴らも江戸を落としたことで天狗になってやがるだろうが、その鼻っ柱を叩き寄ってやろうぜ。奴らの驚く顔が目に浮かぶね。もう俺たちは鳥羽伏見の時とは違うんだからな。
Nagakura beamed with confidence, which perhaps had been the influence of his new techniques. The Seikyo corpse had been broadening his horizons.
とりあえず、長旅で疲れてるだろ。宿を用意してあるから休んどけよ。
いや、疲れてはいねえから気は使わねえでくれ。それより、お前に話してえことがあるんだ。
そんなの後でいいじゃねえか。彼女も長旅で疲れてるだろうし。さあ、千鶴ちゃん、行こうぜ。一番綺麗な部屋を用意してあるからな。
ああ。Thank you. After offering him my thanks, Nagakura became giddy with excitement. He had practically been pushing us through the front door.Later that evening, Nagakura came bursting into our room, and in his hand was a decanter full of a clear liquid.
ほらほらほら、見ろよ、サノ。奮発して高い酒買ってきてやったぜ。かあ、あれってどこまで優しいんだろうな。こんな素晴らしい酒を独り占めせず、お前に飲ましてやるなんて。
あのな、新八。酒を飲む前に話が。
バカ野郎、何言ってやがんだよ。まずは口の滑りをよくしねえと始まらねえだろ。
Nagakura was bouncing off the walls more excited than I had ever seen him before. Why are you so happy? I interpreted it as his way of celebrating the fact that Harada and I had made safe passage en route to Utsunomiya.Watching Nagakura buzz with glee made it hard for Harada to turn him down a second time.
そうだな。そんじゃ、一杯だけ。
With a little more sake in his belly, Nagakura began opening up, and the pace of his voice quickened from when he started his sentence to when it finally ended.
そういえばさ、まだ市営館にいた頃、みんなで吉原に遊びに行った時のこと覚えてるか?
いつのことだそりゃ。
ほら、近藤さんが初めてくっついてきた時のことだよ。
You what?
やっぱりさ、ああいう店に行くと姉ちゃん方はみんな土方さんとかお前のところに行っちまうだろ。男は見た目が10割だからな。そんな中、近藤さんも内心モテてって思ってたんだろうな。何を思ったか、自分の口にげんこつ入れる宴会芸始めやがってよ。
No way they actually mentioned that. So this is true. In the book that I've read, and I think in some other places as well, they mention how Kondo-san would fit his entire fist into his mouth for entertainment purposes. It's stupid. And I can't believe it's here as well.
ああ、思い出した。大受けだったな、ありゃ。いろんな意味で。
そうそう、姉ちゃんたちゲラゲラ笑っててさ。モテてるっていうより笑われてんだ。だけど近藤さん、姉ちゃんたちにキャーキャー言われたのが嬉しかったみたいで、顔あからめてやがったんだよな。
いや、笑われてることには気づいてたと思うぜ。 ああいう店で姉ちゃん方に指さされて笑われても軽く受け流せる人なんだ。あの人にはそういうとこがあっただ
な。あとあれも覚えてるか、土方さんが俳句をこっそり書き留めてた口調を掃除のやつが見つけてきて、それがまたすげえ下手くそでみんなで大笑いしてたとこにちょうど土方さんが戻ってきてさ。
Your son is still alive.
あったあった、あの人のあんな顔見たのは後にも先にもあれっきりだな。
Harada and Nagakura eagerly traded stories of their youth, reminiscing in the past as they whittled away the liquor from the decanter one shot at a time. Most of the stories came from their earlier days at Shiei Hall. It was Kondo-san this, or Hijikata-san that, or Okita this. Each story was recounted so vividly, revealing tidbits of information about people from whom I had grown to deeply admire.It almost felt like I was there. Somehow, not only had they told each the tale convincingly, but without a hint of negativity, too. They clinked their glasses every 5 minutes, toasting to the memories of what used to be, which seemed totally at odds to where they left off with Kondo-san. Soon, Nagakura's speech became slurred, and he blinked one eye at a time as he looked back at Harada. He became drunk, all right.
で、今日は何があったんだ？お前がそういう飲み方する時って、大抵何かあった時だろ。
Yeah, that's true. I'm gonna guess it's the other way we're going with this.As an outsider, the interaction was what I expect when two friends were connected after a long period of absence, basking in each other's company, but Harada knew Nagakura well enough to spot the difference. It's gonna be what I think it is, isn't it? Nagakura fell silent. He toyed clumsily with his cup in between his fingers, watching what remained of his sake slush inside of the cup for a moment until...
Yubesa...近藤さんの夢見たんだ。あの岩みてえな顔で腕組みしながらずっと黙っててさ、夢の中で俺あの人に言いてえことをいつもの調子で言いまくってたんだよ。近藤さん、俺の言葉が聞こえてんだか聞こえてねえんだかわかんねえ感じで何も言わずに座ってたんだが、最後にさ、いきなり頭を下げて、すまなかったって一言だけ言って、そのままどこかに行っちまったんだ。目覚めた時、俺もしかしたらもう近藤さんに会えねえんじゃねえかって思っちまってさ。おかしいよな、てめえの都合で飛び出したのに、どうして今更あんな夢を見るんだよ。
Nagakura looked just as ready to burst into tears as he was into laughter, and without another word, he gulped down the remaining sake from his cup. I watched their entire conversation unfold from off to the side, silent and sober. The more inebriated Nagakura became, the more I realized why he had greeted us so fervidly. For Nagakura, Harada was all that tethered him to the memories of their past. Everyone else had either split off in a different direction or was no longer with us.
Nah, Sano. Nanda ganda de, Shiegan no koro kara issho ni iru no te, omae dake ni nachimatta yo.
Da na.腐れ縁もいいとこだ。
そりゃお互い様だってよ。だけどさ、せっかくここまで来たんだし、思ったら
Please don't tell me he's falling asleep. Nagakura's face was completely flushed with color and he fell to the floor mid-sentence, snoring as he entered a deep, drunken stupor. Yeah, I figured.
ガキじゃねえんだからもう少し綺麗に飲めねえもんかな。
Harada rolled his eyes from secondhand embarrassment as Nagakura's snoring filled the room. Even as Harada poked fun at Nagakura's boorish behavior, there was a very genuine feeling of love between them, one that could never be broken. Today, Nagakura did all of the talking and Harada did all of the listening.The rhythm of their conversation suggested that they could just easily have switched roles, a close rapport developed over years of sharing drinks and stories.
Chizuru, 面倒かけて悪いが、こいつを部屋に運んで布団敷くのを手伝ってくれるか。廊下にでも転がしておきてえとこだが。明日目覚ました時にギャーギャー言われるのも鬱陶しいからな。
Together we hoisted the unconscious Nagakura on our shoulders to his room and tucked him in.
Yare, yare. 話すきっかけを見失っちまったな。あの野郎、話の腰を片っ端から折りやがって。悪いな。明日こそはあいつとちゃんと話をするから。
Please, there's nothing to apologize for. While it was true that there were still pressing matters to which we needed to attend, that sadly Nagakura had become too drunk to discuss. To some extent, I knew that Harada hadn't wanted to sink the mood of their conversation either. I, just as much as Harada, wanted to savor what time we may have had left with Nagakura. Or at least, this was the impression I gathered from the melancholic expression on Harada's face.
新八のやつめ。せっかくの高い酒だってのに、あんなこと言いやがるから、全然酔えなかったぜ。
Talk through the whole thing? Harada paused for a moment, curling his lips in hesitation, before he expanded upon his point. He gazed up at the ceiling, inhaling a deep breath as he shut his eyes. He ran his thin, coarse fingers through his hair.Finally, he opened up his eyes, speaking as though he were confessing something to me.
実はさ、俺も昨夜、近藤さんの夢を見たんだ。
Gee, okay.
新八と違って話はできなかったが、何か言いたそうにずっと黙ってたな。二人で似たような夢を見るなんて、えらい偶然だよな。
Yeah, about that omen.
しかも、夢の内容を考えると嫌な予感しかしね
え。 It was tough for me to offer any input, and instead I lowered my gaze towards the floor. Nagakura had his own reasons for leaving, but Harada's only reason for abandoning his life with the Shinsengumi, including everyone he had cared about, was me.If Harada were still with the Shinsengumi, then perhaps none of the existential problems that he currently faced would have been a problem for him. If I were an ordinary girl, then Harada would have had no reason to uproot his entire life, leaving behind his beloved group of friends and his position just to protect me. Now I had to put Harada in the position of abandoning his best friend, all because of my selfish needs.How crushing was it for him to bid farewell to arguably the most important person in his life? Doubly so for Nagakura, who had no idea that his best friend would soon embark on a life or death mission.
お前、そろそろ休んだ方がいいぜ。女の足でここまで来たんだ。疲れてるだろう。
I'm fine. I...
明日には江戸にトンボ帰りの予定なんだ。休んでおかねえと持たねえぞ。
Harada's resolve was stronger than I anticipated. Come hell or high water, he was determined to lead the two of us back into Edel. You're right. I'll get some sleep. Harada nodded curtly toward me, and I quietly slinked towards the direction of my bedroom. Carefully navigating the dimly lit hallway, I passed by Nagakura's room. He had quite a bit to drink, and I wondered to myself whether or not the alcohol had left his system. Out of concern, I suddenly poked my head into his room when... My head bumped into Nagakura, who was, to my surprise, had one of his feet out of the door. Oh, no, please don't apologize. It was rude of me to enter unannounced. You seem to be having so much fun drinking and reminiscing with Harada. I assumed that you were just excited to see each other. Don't be. If anything, all it shows is how much fun you and Harada had together.
まあ、それももちろんあるんだけどよ。またあいつと戦えるって思ったら、体がうずうずしてきちまってさ。
エンツィ？
サノはとにかく強いからよ。背中を預けた時、あいつほど安心できるやつってのもそうそういねえからな。新選組を抜けた今、あいつと一緒にどんな戦い方ができるのか楽しみで仕方ねえんだ。
Nagakura's eyes beamed with enthusiasm. Ever since he was a boy, Nagakura fostered ambitions to become a renowned warrior, leaving his domain to dedicate his life to tireless training. For Nagakura to admit, without hesitation, how much he relied upon Harada was telling. A stunning realization hit me. There was no way I could bear to take Harada away from his best friend on the battlefield.It was a feeling that arose from the very bottom of my soul. Nagakura poked me with his elbow in a joking manner, then stumbled his way into the hallway towards the kitchen. Thank you, Nagakura. Thank you for helping me realize. Because of you,I realize what needs to be done. This is how we're ending it. Say goodbye to Harada.